Hey guys, Dad Gizmo's back. And I'll tell you, they just don't make appliances like they used to. So we have the Samsung multi-steam vent sensor dryer. You're probably asking yourself why the front of it's pulled off of it. And that's because it stopped working and made a bunch of noise. And so, you know, I could Google with the best of them, find the videos to fix the problem. So we started looking at what the problem was with our less than three-year-old dryer. And the dryer was making all kinds of noise, and we started realizing that pieces of this felt were in our clothes. And so it wasn't off the front of it, it was off the back side of it. And you could start seeing it started, more and more of it started coming off. Well, mom and dad's old dryer is probably 10, 15 years old. It's ugly, it's faded. The buttons don't match the outside of it anymore, but that thing just works and continues to work. So it's hard to get rid of it. This one's less than 3 years old and doesn't work. And now thanks to me, it's in pieces. The good news for me is when I started looking at what was wrong with this thing, I went, oh, this felt thing needs to be replaced. No big deal, get a new piece of felt, put it in. That's not that simple with this dryer. You need to replace this entire spinning drum if you have that problem. It's actually secured to it. You have to replace the entire drum. They say you can glue pieces on it, but let's be honest, who wants to glue something onto their dryer that has heat and things going through it? The last thing you want is a fire. So I was just going to replace this entire drum. So I took it apart, and I realized that not only the felt was all ripped off of it, which, you know, was a problem, but now I can't even fix this dryer any longer. So less than 3 years old, can't fix, was it 800, probably a little bit more money, dryer. So I started looking at it before I ordered the parts, thank God, because this drum is $300+. And that's if you really have the guts to rip this thing apart. And I clearly did. So going through it, I looked at it, I was gonna order this new drum. I wanted to make sure that I could take it apart and get the new drum. And as I was doing it, you can see that the piece where that drum was sitting on is just, it's like aluminum can. It's like a Coke can. So the whole metal piece where this piece sits on across the entire top and side is completely gone. Not fixable, gone. Terribly disappointing for something that's as expensive as this. It looks like such a great unit, a great washer and dryer, and then this happens. Not fixable, very disappointing. And again, the old 10, 15-year-old washers and dryers don't have this kind of problem. So this whole back piece would have to be replaced with the drum now. So now you're talking a $360 drum, whatever this costs to fix and replace. By the time you did that, you might as well, and that's only what we know is wrong. So we might as well scrap the whole thing and start over. Here's the bad news. We have a beautiful washing machine that works great. It's got all kinds of cool stuff to it. It's pretty much worthless without a matching set. So now I either have to scrap the entire set and start over, or I have to buy the same dryer that lasted me less than 3 years just so I'm matching in my set, which I don't know if I want to sign up for that again. So we know that we at least have $360 worth of damage to this dryer in less than 3 years, plus this. So it's not worth fixing. It's just not worth fixing, because this is, what else is wrong with this at this point, less than 3 years? What else is wrong with this that we just don't know about yet? So I'm not going to bother fixing it. I'm going to have to scrap it. So now again, what do I do? Do I go back and try to get a matching dryer that didn't last me what it should? Or do I scrap the entire Samsung set and start over with a different brand? So let me know what you would do with this. I'll tell you right now, I'm very disappointed in the set that I have right now. It worked great for when it worked, but clearly this must have been either, the felt must have not been on right to begin with. This was either very, very thin to begin with, and it was a defect to start with. But either way, this is worthless, and now I have to figure out how to get rid of it and what I'm gonna do for my next washer and dryer. Okay, so this kind of reminds me of why I sometimes get extended warranties with appliances. So if you watch my other videos, you know we got the extended warranty with the refrigerator. We have a 5-year warranty with that refrigerator. The manufacturer warranty on this is not going to last long enough for you to actually do anything with it. So let's say it's a year. I think it might be a year. Clearly, it's going to last a year. But you're going to have faults that happen like this. So you probably would have been better off having an extended warranty, which I don't have, so it's worthless to me. But now, this is completely a wash for me. I have to really scrap the entire thing. Okay, so that's the video for the day. So let me know two things. Have you had issues with your washer and dryer? What manufacturer and set do you have? Because I don't want to get that one either. Did I just get a lemon? Maybe I just got a lemon, right? It could happen. And leave a comment below and subscribe to us. Give us a thumbs up. We'll show you more videos as we go. Thanks. Bye.